against him would be silenced, oh God, and that somehow a veil would be torn from the eyes of those who can't see, that they would see the glory and the grace of God upon the individual. We pray that prayer now, God, that somehow suddenly eyes would be open and they would see him as he is, a man graced by God to lead a nation in a time as this. So we bless you and we thank you and we glorify in you for continuing to lift him, for continuing to honor him, and by extension, continuing to lift us and honor us as a nation. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. And everybody say amen. Amen and amen.
Thank you, Pastor Sam. Let the people of God say amen. Amen. Thank you. So we are all in the city tonight. And we are in a city of greatness. And the Palrep of Roseau Central is certainly not an ordinary Palrep. And tonight is a great night. It's history in the making. And with that being said, I can think of no better person to do the welcome and the honor. So, labor rights, let me hear you. Labor rights, the woman behind the greatness herself, but the rock, the pillar that inspires that greatness, the parliamentary representative of the Roseau Central constituency. Let me hear you. Honorable Melissa Skerritt. Let me hear you. Let's make a big welcome to the city.
Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, Senior Minister, Honorable Austrey, and all my cabinet colleagues, and to you, Liberites, welcome. It's been so long since we have come together like this to celebrate and to remind ourselves of the strength of labor. You know, this morning I jumped up in my bed. I was so excited. I say, you know what? Today he must touch down. And I went to look for some wall space, Senior Minister Housing. I need a new wall because I don't have enough space to add to the different accolades that he has received. The order of Jose Marti conferred on my husband, the Prime Minister of our great country, gives us the opportunity to reaffirm our support to our leader, to our party, but most importantly, to the continued advancement of Dominica. Brothers and sisters, Liberites, I welcome you to the heartbeat of Dominica. I welcome you to the fastest developing city in the Caribbean, the city of the future, Roseau Central. I have to say, among the 18 seats held by this Labour Party, several are considered strongholds, We can call on Vegas, Grand Bay, Portsmouth. They are regarded, St. Joe, they are regarded as the base of the party. And many of our party stalwarts call these constituencies home. But I tell you this evening that the Labour Party, you have found a new base, a new stronghold in the Roseau Central constituency. Roseau Central is firmly in the mix. It is in the boyo of the Labour Party. And they can walk all they want in the city, but we shall not be moved. Firstly, on behalf of myself and our children, Dimitri, Isabella, and Malik, and the people of the Roseau Central constituency, I congratulate my husband, the Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, on this stunning achievement. And join me in giving him a round of applause. Blow your horns wherever you are. Let's give him a round of applause. We are incredibly proud of Roosevelt Skerritt, the man, Roosevelt Skerritt, the father, Roosevelt Skerritt, the leader of the Dominica Labour Party, and Roosevelt Skerritt, the distinguished Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of Dominica. Brothers and sisters, I want you to fully appreciate the significance of the honor received by our dear leader. The Order of Jose Marti is Cuba's highest national honor given to foreign heads of government who have proven themselves as leaders of distinction, advocates of disadvantaged groups around the world, and proponents of peace, security, and social well-being of people. The award recognized our Prime Minister for all his efforts in consolidating the bonds of friendship and cooperation with Cuba, and for his courage in defending just causes. His outstanding leadership to achieve wider and more effective integration between the nations of Latin America and the Caribbean, and his firm support for the lifting of economic blockade of the United States government against Cuba were also cited. And as Labourites, we do not have to look far for the evidence of our Prime Minister's care and concern for his people. A mere stone's throw away stands the City Breeze Apartments. Our elderly are enrolled in the Yes We Care program. The National Employment Program ensures that over 3,000 nationals are gainfully employed. Hundreds of children are pursuing education. These are just a sample of the initiatives undertaken by the Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt. In recognition of our esteemed leader by the Republic of Cuba is another reminder that leadership matters. And when all is said and done, Roosevelt Skerritt still remains the one who has the proven track record of service and development and of effective political leadership. Our leader stands tall among the rest. A man of integrity and impeccable statesmanship, held in the highest regard around the globe. The Dominica Labour Party family stands proud. And so today, I mark today as the beginning of his celebration as we approach his 50-year birthday jubilee. And so today, we are going to cherish and honor the man who has sacrificed the better half of his life for the men and the women and the children of this country. And that is why he's not going anywhere. He's not going nowhere. Because when the mighty hand of God installs a good leader, only the good Lord can remove him. And so we say to the Wednesday walkers who are loitering and littering our city on a Wednesday walking, we say to them, they can walk all they want in the city. They can even run up Constitution Hill. They can even go and swim in the Rosa River. But we shall not be moved.
Shall not be moved.
Something tells me you are fired up and you are ready to place your firm support behind your leader. And this evening, we celebrate his achievement. Tomorrow, with renewed enthusiasm, we get back to the business of building this country for the future happiness and well-being of every Dominican citizen. We again welcome you, Labour!
Rosa, we ready. Bossy, we ready. Sandro, we ready. Mao, we ready. Rosa, we ready. Bossy, we ready. Sandro, we ready.
Red,
we ready.
Hot.
We ready.
Thank you, Pal Rep Rosa Central. I told you all that I could think of no better person to do a welcome, and what a wonderful welcome. Labour, ladies and gentlemen, Labourites, the special thing about this Prime Minister has been his life of sacrifice. Everything about Roosevelt Skerritt has been sacrifice. From the moment that he was born to this very day and all the days that he will continue to be with us. And if you see here, just before I came back to the podium, his wife spoke. And I will tell you, just from my very short time in the political arena, I know the sacrifices. I know the work and I know the vocation. For the Prime Minister, it has been 20 years of sacrifice, of vocation, of dedication to you and country. But even with that, he has brought his dear wife into it as well, to sacrifice. And that is how the Prime Minister inspires, ladies and gentlemen. And with his years of sacrifice, he has come to inspire many people in Dominica and across the world. That is why the world celebrates with Roosevelt Skerritt. And ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, we'll have some solidarity messages tonight. You will have some good people who will come to the podium and tell you how they personally and have been inspired by his greatness. And we have representatives from our LYOs, from our LWO, from our party structure itself, and some of our colleagues, parliamentarians, the senior minister, who have all been touched in a personal way by the Prime Minister. So, ladies and gentlemen, we will first call to the stage. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we know it's raining a lot here in Roseau. And I am also being informed that there is even more rain in the east right now. And we have a few flooding situations that we are monitoring at this moment also. So we're continuing to keep a close eye on that. Be assured that various structures are in place right now to ensure that if we have any occurrences, that they will be cleared and dealt with very swiftly and sternly. All right, so we will continue to inform you and let you know as things progress. But ladies and gentlemen, with that being said, we have to continue to be grateful. And we are going to hear our messages of solidarity right now. we invite to the stage a young man from Canefield who's representing one of our LYOs, a man who is a community leader, an avid sportsman, a father, an engineer, a young professional, someone I know who has been inspired by the greatness and the likeness of Roosevelt Skerritt. Ladies and gentlemen, join me and all in welcoming to the stage Mr. Edmond Laville from the community of Canefield.
Let me start by saying a pleasant good evening and welcome to our Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt. A pleasant good evening to ministers of government and senators, and most importantly, a pleasant good evening to all of you labor rights. In the lead up to the 2008 U.S. presidential elections, a reporter asked Barack Obama at the time what was a very important question. And that question was about the state of the affairs within the African American community and what would he do once elected to alleviate the plight of that community. Barack Obama's response was remarkable. His response was forthright and poignant. Barack Obama said in no uncertain terms that the American youths and the young adults should find themselves greater role models and mentors within their community to emulate, point blank and center. You see, the former U.S. president, he knew how quintessential positive and influential role models are to the social development and upliftment of his people and his race. Now let's home in to Dominica. Within the Dominican context, we are here to pay homage to such an individual as described by the former U.S. president, none other than Dr. the Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt. Now, every Dominican youth and every Dominican young adult who holds ambitions to be somebody or simply make something great of themselves and their lives Sunday no longer has to look beyond the shores of Dominica to find such a leader, to find someone as a positive and influential role model to which they can emulate. For we have it right here now. We have such a leader right here now in the person of the Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt. Now, not only did he become the world's youngest head of government at the time, allowing absolutely no man to despise his youth. We know as the youth, young adults, and young people, we are smart, we are talented, we are intelligent. And just like the Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, we should not allow anyone or any man to tell us that we cannot do what he has just done. You know, the Holy Bible says, where there is no vision, the people will perish. Where there is no vision, the people perish. Boldly and presumptuously, I might add, did the Honorable Prime Minister elucidate his vision to the world that he desires that Dominica become the first climate resilient nation. So much so that an honorary doctorate from Deakin's University in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, was bestowed upon him in recognition of his leadership and advocacy in climate change. Likewise, my friends, likewise the youth, likewise young adults. Just as the Honorable Prime Minister convinced the UN and the entire world to buy into his vision, to buy into the vision of an island boy, we, the youth and young adults, must formulate a vision for ourselves. We must formulate a vision for our future. And by extension, we must formulate a vision for our country, just like the Honorable Prime Minister is doing. Throughout the years, I have made some observations and I've come to this conclusion. A great and influential leader must personify the following characteristics. A great and influential leader must personify the following characteristics: love and compassion, courage, fear and acknowledgement of the Almighty, and wisdom. Love and compassion, for we have heard it time and time again, and these are not my words. In order to lead a people, you must first love a people. And I must confess, the Honorable Prime Minister, he even shows love and compassion to his enemies. And if we were to be honest, most of us want to contend with those who contend with us. We want to fight with those who fight with us. But we have heard it. We have heard the Prime Minister said, let them alone. Forgive them. Let their own oil fry them. Courage. It takes courage to make decisions and to take action. The Prime Minister exhibited courage to join ALBA. It took courage to switch diplomatic relations from Taiwan to the People's Republic of China. Fear and acknowledgement of the Almighty and wisdom can be harmonized in this. The fear of the Lord, right, is the beginning of wisdom. And as I conclude, congratulations to our Honorable Prime Minister for being a great and influential leader, being recognized internationally for being so. Congratulations for being bestowed the Order of Jose Marti from the Government of the People's Republic of Cuba.
Thank you very much, and thank you, Edmond, for such inspiring words. And this is exactly what labor is about, inspiration. This is exactly what PM is about, inspiration and young people. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure and privilege to also invite another young person, a young female this time, to the podium in the person of Lakia Joseph, a young lady from the community of Benz, a young professional, a business person, a community leader, an inspirational person in her own right, a youth parliamentarian. Let us all welcome Miss Lakia Joseph. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. Good evening. And good evening to you, Mr. Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt. And to everyone listening, my name is Lakia Joseph, and I'm here to offer a few words of encouragement, of congratulations to our Prime Minister, Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerrin. Honorable Prime Minister, you have done it again. Dominicans, we have done it again. God has done it again. Once again, we stand in solidarity with our leader, and we extend our congratulations to you, sir, for your exemplary service and selfless leadership. To the Republic of Cuba, I echo the sentiments of my people to simply say thank you. Thank you for your loyalty and camaraderie over the last few decades, and today for acknowledging our prodigious, exceptional, and legendary Prime Minister with the country's highest award, the Jose Marti Award. Average leaders raise the bar for themselves. Good leaders raise the bar for others. Great leaders inspire others to raise their own bar. But our leader, Dr. Roosevelt Skerrin, has concreted the fact that we are our own bar. What an incredible man. What a phenomenal leader. What a remarkable role model. As a young female leader, a young female advocate, a young female entrepreneur, and a young female youth parliamentarian, I understand that a great leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. And Honorable Prime Minister and my fellow Dominicans, this is the way. My fellow Dominicans, only a dynamic leader can lead us into the realms of a dynamic nation. As young Dominicans and uprising exemplary citizens, it is important to have a leader such as you, Honorable Skerrin. We understand that the quality of a leader and his leadership is reflected in the standards he set for himself. And you, sir, have set the standards extremely high. The Jose Marti Award serves to promote and reward the activities of outstanding merit in accordance with the ideals and spirit of Cuban independence leader, thinker, and poet Sir Jose Marti. The Jose Marti Award went all over the world, and tonight it has landed on Dominican soil. And it has landed because of our Prime Minister's peace, camaraderie, and equality. We salute you, sir. As youth, we understand that today we are not just serving for ourselves, we are serving for our people. The youth are enthusiastic, optimistic, and energetic. And once that energy is channeled efficiently, we will reach unfathomable heights. As youth, we need leaders we can relate to. We need leaders who are powerful but not harsh, kind but not weak, aggressive but not a bully, modest but not arrogant, proud but not conceited. We need leaders like Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerrin. And to be honest, this is not a Roosevelt Skerrin accolade. It is not a Labour Party accolade. It is a Commonwealth of Dominica accolade. This award is historical. It is transformational. It is metamorphical. It is dynamic. So to you, Honorable Prime Minister, these few words on behalf of myself, the youth, and the people of Dominica will never be enough to express our love and our pride for this award being given to you. But we celebrate this momentous occasion with you. But we want to tell you, Honorable Skerrin, that we love you, we are proud of you. Thank you for your principled leadership and your selfless service. And behind every great man is an even greater woman. So to Mrs. Skerrin, thank you for being an incredible partner and wife. Roosevelt Skerrin from Vacars, This is Lakia Joseph from Benz extending my sincere congratulations to you. Because when it good, say it good. May God bless our Prime Minister and may he bless our beautiful island, Dominica.
Thank you very much, Ms. Joseph, for your inspiring, your touching words. I recall when I spoke with you and we asked you to give some messages of solidarity. I asked you to make our PM cry, and you have come close to that, I am sure. And if they think labor easy, behind labor have labor. So thank you, Lakia. Certainly proud of you. I'm now going to invite another woman to the stage, another powerful woman, someone who is certainly no stranger to the stage, representing the LWO, Labour Women's Arm of our party, Ms. Tammy Jean-Jacques, a community leader, particularly in the area of Kings Hill, a former senator herself. Let's make her feel welcome, everyone.
Thank you, Senator Laville. Good evening to the political leader of the Dominica Labour Party, Dr. the Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt, the man of the hour, other distinguished guests, Laborites, friends, all. It is indeed a pleasure for me to present this message of solidarity to you, our political leader, on behalf of the Labor Women's Organization and all women of Dominican descent by extension. Today, Laborites at home and abroad celebrate with you on the achievement of yet another accolade. You have a distinguished record in the defense of human rights with a special contribution to education, culture, governance, and the well-being of our people. We know that women hold a special place in your heart. Under your leadership, we have seen considerable progress being made in empowering women and girls by providing opportunities for quality higher education, training, and access to funding for small businesses, including the craft and cottage industries, advancement in managerial and policy formulation levels. In quasi-government organizations and the public sector, many more women hold CEO and other top managerial positions. 80% of our permanent secretaries are women, and the country boasts 35% women parliamentarians and 38% as elected representatives. Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, you continue to structure the housing revolution to look after single parents who are predominantly women so as to hold the family together. Your brainchild, the Yes We Care program, caters to the needs of our elderly and vulnerable citizens, so many of whom are women. Most recently, when we were at a heightened risk during the COVID-19 pandemic, you spared no efforts in acknowledging the tremendous contribution of the women on the front lines of disease treatment, prevention, and containment. We know that you love and cherish all women. We feel it with every decision made in charting the path to prosperity for this country. On behalf of all Dominican women, I extend a heartfelt thank you to the government and people of the Republic of Cuba for bestowing the award of Jose Marti upon our beloved Prime Minister and political leader. Congratulations, Dr. the Honorable Roosevelt Skerrit. The women of Dominica salute you. You deserve it. Thank you.
We shall not be moved.
We shall not be moved.
Not by the trees, not planted by the waters.
Labour Party shall not be moved.
Thank you very much, Tammy. And certainly in Labour Party, we know for something to work, we must involve our LWO. In fact, we must make them lead it for it to work very well. So respect the power of Labour women, ladies and gentlemen. We know the rain is falling, showers of blessings, yes, but we know it's not easy. We know many of you want to speak and say something to the Prime Minister about the way he has impacted us, but we'll keep it short. So with that being said, we're going to have two more very brief words of solidarity. So we'll call to the stage right now, Ambrose George, Ambassador Ambrose George, former minister, member of parliament, and come to the stage, please, sir.
Labour! Thank you. A very pleasant good evening to all. I would like to recognize of us, among us, Dr. Roosevelt Skerrit, our Prime Minister and political leader, and his wife and children, members of cabinet, our distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good night to every one of you. I want to begin by offering my personal and sincere congratulations to the Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerrit, the Prime Minister, political leader and parliamentary representative for the Vickers constituency on receiving the order of Jose Marti from the government of the Republic of Cuba. This prestigious award is of international acclaim, and the selection process is very instructive and is carried out by many eminent figures. The Jose Marti Award is bestowed upon a recipient with very high distinction. Prime Minister Skerrit now joins the ranks of recipients such as President Hugo Chavez and Nelson Mandela, the President of South Africa. This is indeed a very proud moment for all of us here in Dominica, at home and abroad. And every word of congratulations is very much appreciated. Prime Minister Skerrit has been and continues to be a very close friend and ally of the people and the government of the Republic of Cuba. He has consistently called for the removal of the blockade on the people and the government of the Republic of Cuba. Dr. Roosevelt Skerrit has on every occasion called for the honor and respect for the charters of the United Nations and the adherence to international law. Very often, you would hear him remind us that our beautiful and peaceful country, Dominica, is ruled by law and not by man. As the longest serving Prime Minister, we have witnessed a number of very important initiatives taken on behalf of the people of our beloved country and the region on a whole. Here I speak to the Petro-Caribe Initiative, the Miracle Eye Program, the Cuban Scholarship Program, the establishment of the Alba Bank, the Cuban Medical Brigade, and the list goes on and on. So now, brothers and sisters, it is a time to celebrate and to give our thanks for a very progressive leader who is recognized internationally and who has the vision, the foresight, and the intelligence and the leadership qualities to take our people and our country, Dominica, to prosperity. Congratulations, dear Prime Minister. You continue to make us proud. Hip, hip, hip. Hooray. Hip, hip, hip. Hip, hip, hip. Labor. 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 Long live our Prime Minister. Long live the Dominica Labour Party. Thank you.
Thank you very much, comrade. Thank you for your sacrifice also, your leadership and your inspiration for a very, very long time. It's good to have you back on the microphone, inspiring us in a big way. At this point, we'd like to welcome to the podium Minister of State in the Ministry of Blue and Green Economy, someone who was on the journey with the Honorable Prime Minister when he received the most distinguished accolade in Cuba to be called to the Jose Marti Order. And I call to the podium at this point Honorable Caressa Rivera. Thank you.
Labor! Labor! Wow, wow, wow. Rain, storm, thunder, lightning. We are out in our numbers to congratulate our Prime Minister on this receiving this prestigious award. I want to offer my personal congratulations to the Honorable Prime Minister and that of the congratulations on behalf of the Marigot constituency. I was extremely happy to be part of this delegation, and I must say to you that I saw our leader in action, ladies and gentlemen. I witnessed with my own bare eyes, leader per excellence, ladies and gentlemen. Brothers and sisters, the conferment of the Order of Jose Marti Award on our Prime Minister is testament that we have a leader who ranks among the top leaders in the world, ladies and gentlemen. Leaders who believe in world peace, leaders who believe in justice, leaders who believe in care for humanity, ladies and gentlemen. Leaders such as Michael Manley, Hugo Chavez, and the great Nelson Mandela, ladies and gentlemen. Right here from the community of Vakers, we have Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt receiving that award, and we have to be very thankful. We have to say congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, Honorable Skerritt received this award with a sense of humility. His response was punctuated with a call for justice, a call for peace, a call for love and harmony in the world. His response was punctuated with a firm commitment that Dominica will continue to stand with Cuba through darkness, through light, through good times, and also through bad times. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the commitment from our dear Prime Minister. It was punctuated with a clear understanding that we understand the pains and struggle of people across the world. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, PM Skerritt came across as a very trusted leader. He came across as a leader of integrity, a leader who cares, a leader who we can depend on, ladies and gentlemen. He came across as a leader who will stand with you even in the most difficult times. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the kind of leadership that we need in Dominica now. This is the kind of leadership, ladies and gentlemen, that we need in Dominica now. Brothers and sisters, I want to big up my other friends who were part of the delegation. Sister Addis King, put your hands together for Sister Addis King. Honorable Fidel Grant, put your hands together for Honorable Fidel Grant. We had our security, Mr. Sebastian, he's somewhere wrong. And ladies and gentlemen, we had somebody else, a very distinguished lady in the name of Barbara Daly, who did an excellent job. Put your hands together for her, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, finally, in Cuba, when Honorable Skerrit was received, I saw media houses, scores of media houses, ladies and gentlemen, rushing, trying to get a glimpse of our Honorable Prime Minister. Today, in Dominica, I see a sea of red shouting, Skerrit! 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 Ladies and gentlemen, so let us continue to be strong. Let us continue to work together. Let us not be distracted, ladies and gentlemen. We have a good leader in the name of Honorable Roosevelt Skerrit. Let us support our leader. Let us support our leader so that we can lift this country higher and higher, ladies and gentlemen. God bless the Honorable Dr. Roosevelt Skerrit. God bless labor rights all over Dominica. God bless the people of Dominica. May God continue to bless us all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. Skerrit.
Let me tell you something about Caressa. Caressa wasn't down on our program, you know, to begin with. But Caressa called me yesterday to ask to be part of this. Caressa came running out of the plane today and he said, comrade, I must say something. Caressa said, from watching the interaction of the people with PM, he said in his own style, we cannot be wishy-washy about the prime minister. You don't see the way the people in Cuba celebrating the PM? And we joking in Dominica, boy. We can't play around like this. Labor! Ladies and gentlemen, we'll now invite someone very special to this Dominica Labor Party. He's known by so many different names. The Rottweiler. Austria. I'm not going to say the one she just told me there. I cannot say that. But someone who has sacrificed his life for the Labour Party and for Dominica. Possibly the longest serving parliamentarian currently, and we must be proud of this also. And while he's just a couple years older than the prime minister, one or two, he looks good. Age is just a number. But while he's just a few years older than the prime minister, he has the most profound respect and admiration for Honorable Roosevelt Skerrit. I recall being in a meeting with senior minister last night. He was acting prime minister in that capacity. And I said, comrade, are you ready to speak? He said to me, I've been on so many trips with Roosevelt Skerrit, I good to go. So while he's a few years older, he has the most profound love, respect and appreciation for his little brother. So let us all join in welcoming to this podium Senior Minister, Honorable Reginald Ostray!
Labour Party shall not be moved.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. You can call me whatever name you want if you want, but just don't get on my wrong side. Because you get on my wrong side, my brother, you will have it. Let me say a pleasant good evening to Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt and Mrs. Skerritt, my other cabinet colleagues, and you, the members and supporters of the Dominican Labour Party. It didn't take us long to mobilize people to come down here last night. Because I understood that while we were waiting for the Prime Minister to arrive, labor rights were gathered in their numbers to welcome their hero and their leader home. And so I want to send a message to the opposition. You have to stop provoking labor rights. You have to stop provoking the Dominican Labor Party. Because what you're looking for there is not for you alone. Because if you see, we ask labor right to come down, we will swallow you. We'll just swallow you. Because we'll not bring 50, we'll not bring 25, but we'll bring thousands of labor rights down to Roseau to march. And that is why the Prime Minister keeps telling us labor rights to stay put. Stay quiet. Because he know the power of the Labour Party, these little things we have walking up and down Roseau cannot stop the power of the Dominican Labour Party. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, it was my intention to go after some political animals. But the weather is not the best. And I really appreciate the fact that you, the Labourites, have come out to celebrate your leader. And this shows the difference between us and them. Because while they're fighting to destroy their leader, we are fighting to promote and to prop up our leader. And no political party can survive. As you see what is happening in St. Kitts right now with a divided leadership. And that is why we know that no matter how hard they try, the United Workers Party will never form government in this country because they cannot even agree on who to lead that party. So I want to be very short, and so I will use this opportunity just to speak a little bit about Roosevelt Skerritt, and I will leave the political hunting for another time. Because I cannot believe that men who went to Cuba, men who studied in Cuba, men that eat the food of the Cuban people, when the Cuban people were struggling to find food to eat because of the embargo placed upon them by the United States. And you want to tell me today that the Cuban people and the Cuban government has recognized a fighter, has recognized a hero, and to bestow upon him the highest honor that Cuba will ever give. And to disrespect the people of Cuba by making a mockery of the order of Jose Marte. I cannot believe that progressive men who say they're progressive can stoop to such a level just to get that one man called Roosevelt Skerritt. And the Cuban government, the Cuban people will not take this lightly because they sacrificed for you and for us to be something in this country. When they didn't have, they shared the little that they have with us. They gave us their scholarships. They gave us their doctors. They gave us their medical supplies. And for you as somebody who benefited from the benevolence of the Cuban people, rather than congratulate Roosevelt Skerritt and salute him, you want to make a mockery of the highest honor, the highest order that the Cuban people can bestow on anybody. That same order was bestowed on Nelson Mandela. If you disrespect the order bestowed on Skerritt, you disrespecting also the order that was bestowed on Nelson Mandela. And if you're disrespecting the order that was bestowed on Hugo Chavez, if you disrespect the order on Roosevelt Skerrit, you're also disrespecting Hugo Chavez and all these great leaders who have received this serious, serious accolade, the Jose Marti Order. Ladies and gentlemen, not surprised that Roosevelt Skerrit has risen that level. Because Roosevelt Skerrit became Prime Minister in 2004. And in that same year, Green, they called him a novice. He was green. He went to China to seek assistance for this country. And you know the Chinese are the doctors and the fathers of diplomacy. When it comes to diplomacy, you cannot touch the Chinese. They wrote the book on diplomacy. And Roosevelt Skerrit in my presence, I was there. In fact, I went to sleep at 3 o'clock in the morning. Negotiations taking place. And when the Chinese told Roosevelt Skerrit that they had to fly to another city, Skerrit says, no problem, I will be here when you come back. I will wait for you. Go and do your business, and I will wait for you. Because I'm not leaving China before I get what I come to pick up on behalf of the Dominican people. And to see Roosevelt Skerrit, this little man, just turned prime minister to battle it out with the men with the most experience in diplomacy, it was truly an amazing experience which I shall never forget. And I also was there when he joined Petrocaribe and when he joined ALBA. And to see Roosevelt sitting around the table with world Latin American leaders and with world leaders making a case for Dominica and the way the people responded to him, it was truly an amazing experience. And that is why I'm not surprised that Roosevelt Skerrit received that order, because he has shown respect, he has shown principle, he has shown the love for his country and for his people and for the world, and the Cubans in their wisdom. And I'm sure with the nudging of some other international countries, they all agreed that Roosevelt Skerrit is most deserving to receive the highest order of the Cuban government and the Cuban people. Ladies and gentlemen, we have here a gem, because Roosevelt Skerrit represents the future of not only of Dominica, but of poor people all over the world. Because as the older generation began to go, they were worried who would continue the struggle, because there's still a lot of poverty to eradicate. There's still a lot of hunger. There's still a lot of illiteracy. There's still a lot of people going around with not decent health care. And now they found within themselves somebody that they can trust, and somebody on whose shoulder they can trust the development of the world on Roosevelt Skerrit. And if you're not careful, we will lose Roosevelt Skerrit, because Roosevelt Skerrit has now become an international figure. And we must do everything we can to hold on to him, to embrace him, and to allow him to continue his vision for making this country a dynamic country. But like I said, I will limit my remarks to just these few brief points, because we do not have much time, and I want to give the leader himself an opportunity to speak to you, his people, because you came to listen to him, you came to hear him, you came to show him some love, and more admiration, which he truly deserves. He has made us proud, and we have an obligation to make him proud and to thank him for all what in a short time he has done for this country and done for the people of this country. And we have to go after, with no reservations, the people who try to destroy him in whatever way. We have to go after them. We have to protect our leader in any way, shape, or form that we can. And we can only do that, not with fighting, but to show him the solidarity, to show the respect, to show him that we're behind him, and that wherever he go, we will follow. Wherever Skerrit go, we will follow, we'll defend him, we'll protect him. Because without Skerrit at this time, without Skerrit now, we're going to have a big problem in this country. And for those of you here, Labour Party people, who believe that he's been there too long, change your mind. You're making a very sad mistake. And we have to implore on Roosevelt Skerrit that you have to stay on, because the task is not yet complete. We still have a long way to go. And only Roosevelt Skerrit in this period can take us to the promised land of economic and social development. Honorable Skerrit, I want to congratulate you. I want to thank you for all what you've done for this country. for what you've done for your cabinet, for what you have done for me personally. Although I am older, not by 2 years or 3 years, I wouldn't tell you my age, but not by 2 or 3 years, but quite a few years. And I should regard you as my son, but I'm happy to regard you as my father, because you have showed me love, you have taught me well, you have taught me well, and I owe it to you to continue to defend you with every last drop of blood I have in my system, because the defense of Roosevelt's Garrett is a defense for Dominica, is a defense for the oppressed, is a defense for the voiceless, is a defense for the homeless. And I'll continue, Mr. Skerritt, until I have decided to call it quit, to be on your side and to support you in this noble quest of taking Dominica to the promised land. Thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you, Senior Minister. This is why you are called by so many different names. This is why you are so loved. No one could have said it with more passion than you. And only Roosevelt Skerritt can follow that passion. So we know it's raining, showers of blessing, and we need to focus on the East right now and get back to the country's business. You have come to hear your leader. You have come to be in the presence of your hero. So with no further ado, let me now welcome to the stage Dr. the Honorable World Boss, Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Well, you know, tonight I will be speaking in Spanish. So, buenas noches a todos, hermanas y hermanos, compañeros y compañeras, buenas noches a todos, good night. I want to thank all of you for being here. Let me greet the senior minister. Let me greet my wife and Member of Parliament for Rural Central, and Dimitri and Isabella. And of course, to all my colleagues, thank you for your commendation and support. And I greet all of you here tonight who have braved the rain to be here, and you came last night and you're back here today. And I want to say a heartfelt thanks to you. I accepted this honor really on your behalf, the Dominican people, who have placed their trust and confidence in me to lead this country. And so the award was not just for me, it was for the entire nation. But my friends, we view friendship with the Labour Party, and myself personally, that if somebody is your friend, that person is your friend. And there are certain principles that are enshrined within the Labour Party, which I try to exemplify, not only in my interaction with you in Dominica, but in interaction with the rest of the world. And the same way that we have been spending hundreds of millions of dollars to build homes for the people of Dominica, to provide assistance to the senior citizens of our country, to help grow our economy, and to ensure that we can live in peace and harmony in our country, that is the same I would like to see in other countries in the world. But the reality is, my friends, where Cuba is concerned, Cuba has been faced with an embargo for several decades, denying them the opportunity to properly provide for their citizens. But here it is, a country like Cuba, that has so many economic and financial challenges, but has been reaching out to countries like Dominica in providing scholarships to our children and also providing support for our health system. And so we will continue to extend and express our gratitude to the government and people of Cuba. Because when COVID hit us, we were able to rely on Cuba to send doctors and nurses to Dominica to help keep us alive here in Dominica. And so we're grateful to them. When you look at our hospital today, the majority of doctors at the hospital today, Dominicans, were trained by the government and people of Cuba. And several professionals, those who want not to show gratitude to the people who helped them be who they are today, I say, God be with you. Because you cannot come and eat from somebody's hands and then you want to bite that person's hands. This is not what Labour Party is about. Labour Party is about principles. It's about ensuring that we maintain friendship and respect for people and appreciation for people. And that is what the Labour Party is about. And so, ladies and gentlemen, in the midst of COVID here in Dominica, we have been able to hold our strain here in our country. We were the first country in the Caribbean to get vaccines for our people. And not only do we get for ourselves, but we're able to get for others, ladies and gentlemen. And we have vaccines to give everybody 5, 6, and 7 doses. We mobilize ventilators. We didn't keep them for ourselves. We shared it with countries in the Caribbean who didn't have ventilators at the time. That's what we did. Because we understand what being our neighbors keep them in. That in time of need, we have to reach out to each other. Because you never know where you will be tomorrow. And that's what it's about. And that is why the Labour Party has gone ahead and created programs like the Yes We Care program. Saying to our senior citizens that we love you and we care for you. And we're there for you. Because the reality is, my dear brothers and sisters, I treat people the way I would like to be treated. That's how I treat people. And I do not know tomorrow morning, God forbid, I may need the Yes We Care program. And that's what life is. It is not about imposing yourself on people. It's about working with people. Working with people. And so we continue to invest heavily, ladies and gentlemen. We continue to build homes. And I give you the assurance here in Dominica that Labour Party will not rest until every single family in our country has a decent home, ladies and gentlemen. You know, they criticize all of these things, you know. They criticize the housing program. They criticize the Yes We Care, ladies and gentlemen. They criticize us helping people to go overseas for medical care. They criticize the National Empowerment Program, asking for it to stop. But we give you the assurance, ladies and gentlemen, that Labour Party will never abandon its people. Labour Party will never abandon this country. I want to say to the young people of Dominica that never before, and people talk about, oh, well, government must do this and government must do that. And I ask them, why didn't the Freedom Party do it? Why didn't workers do it? Why is it that the Labour Party is the one doing it? And we see how many hundreds of young people have benefited from our education revolution created by the Dominican Labour Party. When we came into government in 2000, only 40% of high school or primary school graduates had access to secondary school. Not because those who didn't make it were not bright, they were not smart, or did not pass the common entrance, But because the system knew how many people they were taking even before we sat the exams. And Labour came into government. And Labour said, we're going to create access for every single child in Dominica. And we said, we're going to take us 5 years to create this from 2002 to 2007. And we created universal access to secondary education in 2005 for every single child in Dominica. And we did not only create access to education, you know. We created the means of having, of taking access, taking advantage of the access. Free transportation for every single child attending secondary school in Dominica. Free books, free uniform, free shoes. Every child can go to school knowing that they have a new bag, a new school shoe, a new school shirt, a new school pants. Maintaining the dignity of our people. And then, ladies and gentlemen, when Labour came into government, only 7% of all high school graduates had access to the college. And we came in. And today, ladies and gentlemen, every single Dominican who graduates from secondary school has access to the state college. No tuition fees. In America, for you to go to community college, you will spend about $8,000 per semester. And in Dominica, it is free of charge for the people. And today, ladies and gentlemen, the average Dominican has access to university. No longer must you have a surname. No longer must you only know somebody in education to get a scholarship. We have sent hundreds of young people, thousands of young people to universities. In America, even if you're American, you have to pay to go to university. American students owe the federal government $1.3 trillion in student loans. So I'm saying to the young people of Dominica that it is always safer and better with the Dominican Labor Party. And you heard the young people speak tonight. Young Mr. Laville and Miss Joseph, you heard them. How powerful they are, how articulate they are, how confident they are, ladies and gentlemen. These are products of the Dominican Labor Party. And look at the cabinet, ladies and gentlemen. Look at the cabinet of ministers, young people, serious leadership roles, because labor is about young people. Labor is about empowering our young people in Dominica. Empowering our young people. So I say, you parents, understand that your children through the Dominican Labor Party. You know, I hear people walking in Roseau every Wednesday. Every Wednesday they're walking. Now, they can walk every single day. Don't wait for Wednesday. Walk every single day. But we have a message for them in the Dominican Labor Party. That the majority of Dominicans believe today that the Dominican Labor Party is the best and only party for Dominica. A bunch of lazy people want to go and run Dominica. Apache Fair. Lazy people. So let them walk. They will achieve nothing by walking. The only thing they can achieve by walking is losing some weight, losing some calories. That's all. And let me tell you, Liberites. Don't worry for me, you know. Don't worry for me, you know. They're attacking me every single day. Every single day. But you know, the moment you see I give them a little prick I will give them, ladies and gentlemen, everybody get upset. Because I know what to tell them. I know what to tell them, ladies and gentlemen. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have to continue working hard in the party. We have to remain united in purpose. We have to do what we have to do for the people of Dominica. And it is not only the responsibility of the ministers and power reps. All of us must play our part on the ground to ensure that Labour Party takes care of its people, ladies and gentlemen. It's important for you to do that. And so, let me tell you, ladies and gentlemen, in regards to foreign policy. We have said that in our foreign policy, we are friends of all and satellites of none. And we have been very consistent with our foreign policy. When there was a war in Iraq, we condemned it. When they invaded Libya, we condemned it. And today there's a war between Ukraine and Russia, we condemn it. We've been consistent. We've been consistent with this. But I can tell you, and I'm saying so with the greatest sense of humility, there's no other time in our history in this country that Dominica was more respected by the international community than it is today, ladies and gentlemen. I don't even tell my colleagues certain things. I don't tell people certain things because for me, it's about humility. But I am telling you that whenever there's any problem in the Caribbean, they call me to ask me their views, ladies and gentlemen. I was late because we had a meeting with the Vice President of the United States of America. And I told them that they have to do better for the Caribbean. They have to do much more for us. That the issue of climate change, which is affecting us every time hurricane season comes or out of hurricane season, they have to mobilize more resources to help countries in the Caribbean. So we are very upfront and honest with people, ladies and gentlemen. But back in the days, we were the Cinderella of the Caribbean. But today, people respect us for who we are. Dominicans can walk throughout the world with their heads up because people have respect for us, ladies and gentlemen. And this is because of the Dominica Labour Party. So, ladies and gentlemen, I am here ready to say thank you to you. Thank you for your continued support. Thank you for your continued love. And very importantly, for your prayers. You are the reason why I'm standing here today, ladies and gentlemen. And I give you this reassurance that the Dominica Labour Party, which I have the honor to lead, will never let you down. We will never let you down. I know sometimes you may feel that you all we're not there and so on, but rest assured, my friends, we will never let you down. And we thank you for your support. We thank you for your support. We'll continue to work in your interests. We'll continue to work in the best interests of your children. So, ladies and gentlemen, this, as I said, this award, this honor is not for me. And Honorable Ostry talk about Dominicans who graduated in Cuba and who have all sorts of things to say. All sorts of things to say. And sometimes you ask yourself, but what kind of people are these people? You see, in politics, my friends, in politics, you're coming to serve people. So you are a servant to the people. You're not their masters. And it's a vocation. And when you are coming to serve people, you must be prepared to make sacrifices. When Christ was selecting his disciples, and some said they're going to tell their wife, and some said they're going to pull their fishing boat, and so he said, no, we have to go. Because they had to make sacrifices. Peter said, but master, I am a fisherman. I'm a fisherman. What about my trade? And you remember Jesus telling him, I shall make you fishers of men. Leave what you're doing. You have to make a sacrifice for the greater good of mankind. But in the Workers' Party, not one of them fellas making any sacrifice. They're coming to see what they can get for themselves, ladies and gentlemen. Not for you. Not for you. When you have to work in the sun to make a dollar, when the farmers have to go in the mountain top to make a dollar, when the fishermen have to go in the sea miles away to make a dollar, when you, the single mothers, may have to do two jobs to make a dollar, this guy's lazy walking Roseau looking for a free payout. Lazy walking in tongue, begging people for a payout, ladies and gentlemen. That is what we want for Dominica. That is what we want for Dominica. So, ladies and gentlemen, let us work together. Let us stay strong. Let us stay united in purpose. We help Dominica to build. And you know, these guys are so silly. I was supposed to come in yesterday. The plane didn't come. It couldn't land. And so many rejoicing. But my friend, you see, like you and me, we put our trust and faith in the Lord. It is the Lord who decides. And the Lord decided that I had to come to Dominica on Friday, ladies and gentlemen. And I have traveled many parts of the world. And sometimes New York has a snowstorm, you can't land. There's heavy rain and thunder in Miami International Airport and you cannot land. Sometimes Barbados Airport is closed because of weather. Give me a break. These guys are so damn stupid, ladies and gentlemen. They're so damn stupid. But we're making progress on our international airport, ladies and gentlemen. And you see, you're seeing the impact which this one direct flight is having from Miami to Dominica on our economy so far. So wait, when we finish that airport, you will see flights coming from Paris, from Amsterdam, from London, from New York, ladies and gentlemen, flying right here in Dominica to complement the investments we're making in agriculture and tourism. So finally, ladies and gentlemen, because I know it's late and it's raining, and we have to go back home. I want to thank all of you for your support. To my colleagues, all of you for your support. And I want to say to you, my dear Dominicans, that we have in this party, in this cabinet, one of the best cabinets you can find anywhere in the world, committed and dedicated to the welfare and well-being of Dominicans. So work well, my friends. Let us not be distracted by these people. Let them do what they have to do, and we will do what we have to do, ladies and gentlemen. We have work to do, and we'll continue working to improve the lives of every single family in Dominica. That's my commitment. That's my commitment. My entire being, my entire commitment is to you, the people of Dominica. And that's a firm commitment to you, my dear brothers and sisters. So thank you for your love. Thank you for your prayers. God bless you. God bless your families. Labor forever, ladies and gentlemen. We shall not be moved in this Commonwealth of Dominica, ladies and gentlemen. Labor all the way, now, tomorrow, and the future, ladies and gentlemen. Because the people say they want labor. The people say labor is the best thing for Dominica, ladies and gentlemen. And so, let us work together. Let us do what we have to do for our country. Let them talk. Talk is cheap, ladies and gentlemen. But let us put talk. Let us continue to work. And you see the caliber of young people Labour Party has, ladies and gentlemen. And I want to say finally to some UWP people. I know that there are some sincere people who support this party. They have invested their time and their resources. But my friends, it is clear that the Workers' Party is going nowhere. It is the worst political party in the whole world, ladies and gentlemen. It has no direction. It has no leadership. It has no principles. It has nothing to offer the people of Dominica. So no matter what they do, ladies and gentlemen, that is not going to change the equation in Dominica, that Dominicans are saying that they're staying with Labour because it is safer with the Dominica Labour Party. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I know your stomach is filled because we have heard our Prime Minister. This is what we wanted. 2 days in the making. We planned it yesterday. It didn't happen. Rain, thunder, lightning, but we had it today in a big way. And ladies and gentlemen, labor rights, this is why we continue to do it. This is why PM continues to do it. It is because of you, your constant support, solidarity, and commitment. This is what keeps PM going and going and going. Thank you, labor rights, for coming out. We know the rain wasn't easy. We know you felt the pressure, but you were there with your hats, with your umbrellas, with everything you had. And we just want to thank you, thank you, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, we have some business to deal with. And we want to make a brief announcement right now. To the people of Dailies, the bus is ready. So please assemble next to the ministry. Please assemble people from the east, people from Dailies. The bus is ready. They're ready to take you home safely. And just to also mention, we have some updates in the east. We have had some flooding events at the Rosalie Bridge in the Tefem area. And we have mobilized two of our largest contractors in the area and equipment operators. So they are in the area, ladies and gentlemen. All the structures are in place. And we will do our best to ensure that the roads are cleared in the quickest time. And ladies and gentlemen, this is what Labour Party is about. This is what we're about. We know there is some pressure in the east with the rain, but we all know that the biggest road project in the history of Dominica is currently ongoing in the east right now, $126 million road project in the east, ladies and gentlemen. So this is what Labour is about. This is what resilience is about. Again, everybody, thank you for your support and your solidarity. We wish all of you a safe journey home. Ladies and gentlemen, the leadership of our Prime Minister is not ordinary. This is truly historic. And we are all happy to be in his presence, in his midst, to be here in this time. It is truly the hand of God, ladies and gentlemen. And ladies and gentlemen, we shall not be moved, and he is still standing. So at this point, we will invite Triple K as he exits with the interlude right now, still standing. Ladies and gentlemen, do enjoy. Thank you. Good night. God bless you. We love you. Labor!
Yo! Youngest drummer tonight, baby.
Yeah.
Yo,
what?
Big up to PM, you don't know.
World boss.
Yo, big up to the world boss. Congrats. Yo. See it.
Hey.
Check it for proper sound. Congrats on your one, man. Austin?
Hey!
Yo. Chad? Hope to see your cousin.
'cause I'm in here to save.
We need the crowd to see something.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We need the crowd to see something.
Let them see.
We have the youngest drummer here on stage.
Everybody checking this frog, yes?
Jamming with TK tonight.
And this boy
is the son
of the bass man.
The son of the bass man.
Yeah.
How old are you, Ivan?
11 years.
He's 11 years old.
Yep.
We're going to do that again. We're starting again. Yeah.
Yes.
Run it.
I'm gonna spend some
Himself. Prototype from poverty, and they still want to ban babies. They don't like don't like we, but we don't like them. Everything we do, they have a problem. Them don't like we, but we don't like them. Everything we do, we want to hold them. When you hold them, we go pass them up. Wow. When you hold them, we go pass them up. True. When you hold them, we go pass them up. Wow. When you ready to mash them up? One, two, let go. Mash them up, 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 we go mash them up, mash them up, we go mash them up, mash them up.
Yeah, like it, I eat. Whoa!
want to see everybody put one hand in the air right now. Let's go. Let's go. Wow. People love your PM, put one hand in the air. Let's go. I love my PM. Best PM. Whoa.
Here we go! just come and get it. You want it, baby girl, you know I got it. You want it, baby girl, just come and get it.
Rudy. Yes.
Rudy, you never own it. All the sexy ladies, all the pretty ladies.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All the nice ladies, ladies, all the sexy ladies, yes, all the pretty ladies.
Yo!
Get on the guy.
Massager,
hey. Massager,
Massager, Lionel, massage it.
Lisha, massage it. I do it alone. Put your hand on the booty. Hey, I'm a zombie booty. Okay. Put your hand on the booty. That's right. Oh, massage. He has been.
Massage.
He has been a pleasure.
Massage.
Well, boss.
Show me how you feel.
Yo! What's this?
Feel.
Get that
it. Show
what?
How feel.
Show you.
Yo!
Show me how you feel. Ooh. Tell me how you feel.
Bad side.
Your father do you there? Yeah.
What your father do?
Big up Ethan, man.
Yeah, man.
Young wicked little drummer.
Yeah, man. So hard work, you know.
We're hot.
The wickedest.
Hard work.
Yeah, man. We're hot. Yeah, just 11 years old, man.
Just 11 years old.
Wicked Mr. Drummer.
Yeah.
We're going out with Tadpole.
Yeah. Yeah, Tadpole. Yeah.
Not a froggy, that's Tadpole.
That's the youngest. Yeah, and man. The wickedest. Better than a man thing.
Yeah, man.
Straight.
And I'll develop some muscle, you know.
How we looking?
Tell me how you feel.
You get there, man?
Let me know.
You have to develop
feel.
Some muscle, you know.
Show me how you feel. And I'll show you how it feels. Tell me how you feel.
Yo!
Yes.
I'll show you how it feels.
Yes, baby. Hey, boss.
Yes.
Yeah.
Show me how you feel.
Show you.
Tell me how you feel.
Wow.
Show you how I feel.
Show me. Show me. Show me.
Tell me what you're looking for. Tell me what you're looking for. Don't say who you checking now. Don't say who you checking for. Go up on my phone, is that for me? No. My problem is that for me? No. Tell me what you're looking for. Tell me what you're looking for. Girl, let me tell you something. You want me on my feelings. Love when you call me bumpy. Love when you call me bumpy. You're looking like a fool. Looking like a fool. You better check my service. I'm not the one who let the one who let the one who let. Who you looking?
Make it weak, baby girl, look up. Turn around, talk it out, put it on, pop it up. Do what you could, make it weak, baby girl, look up.
How's the boy? How we looking?
Yeah, we got a pack up.
Yo!
So you don't know it's bad weather time, so you have to go inside the deal and chill out, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. We're over.
Yo!
All the sexy ladies.
You are the kind of love.
Noise for Ethan.